And first at 5, another person has died in the custody of the Kern County Sheriff's Office. Now, many are raising concerns about the safety of inmates. Thanks for joining us this evening. I'm Rochelle Murcia.
And I'm Michael Patterson. The KCSO is now investigating the death of a 10th inmate in 2023, a staggering number leading many community members to worry about the well-being of inmates. Eyewitness News reporter Leslie Valle spoke with the sheriff on what's being done to ensure safety. Leslie.
That's right, Michael Rochelle. When I spoke with the sheriff, he told me there are various factors when dealing with the death of an inmate and that things aren't as simple as they seem.
It's not the sheriff's fault. We're trying to take care of them the best that we can while they're in custody. We're obligated by law to do that.
With only a few weeks into October, the Kern County Sheriff's Office is now investigating the 10th inmate death of 2023. The inmate's identity hasn't been released, but according to the sheriff's website, the inmate was a 60-year-old African-American man waiting for trial. He died at a hospital on October 6th. The mean and manner of the death is under investigation, but many are questioning why so many inmates are dying in local jails, the current average about one death a month.
The public makes an assumption because somebody dies while they're in custody that they wouldn't have died had they not been in custody. And we know that people die.
Sheriff Donnie Youngblood says he's aware of the speculation, but explains one of the reasons there's so many deaths is because of the inmates' health when they're booked.
It's not physical force that's causing these people to die. They come to us less healthy than the people that are in our communities. They're living on the streets. They're just not in great physical shape. And so they have a tendency to not do well.
But not all inmates this year have died from health issues. Only two inmates died from natural causes, six by suicide, and the other two still under investigation. For those that died by suicide, the sheriff says there's various preventative steps taken while they're in custody, like checking in on them twice every half hour, no more than 15 minutes apart. And for the deaths that are under investigation, it might take longer than usual to determine a cause. Part of the reasoning is due to a nationwide shortage of pathologists.
You don't want to release the wrong information and then go back and have to correct it because then it looks like it doesn't look good.
The sheriff took the time to reiterate that his agency does everything in its power to prevent inmate deaths, and every investigation is taken seriously. In studio, Leslie Valle, Eyewitness News.